Hello. What's going on with my Zoom? Hello, hello, beautiful students. How are you today? I hope that you are pretty fine. Okay, let's continue with our class for today that are going to be pretty interesting. We are going to be talking about different situations that are going to be pretty important. Okay, amazing students. Let's start with this that I have here for you. Tell me, what about your week? Is everything all right? Were you practicing English? Well, little by little. Very good. Let's continue with this that I have here for you, because today we are going to be learning a lot of things, okay? We are going to be doing different exercises, and also we are going to be practicing with some topics that maybe we already know, but we need to be practicing with them a little bit. Well, let's start with it. Ah, super blue today. That's great. So, intermediate level, and let's continue with the class for this day. What are we going to be learning? Let me show you. One more time, my gift for this week. It's great to have you back one more time. And let's continue with our topics. Ready, set, and go. This is high class, big time. So, what are we going to be learning today? Well, let me tell you, during the last class, we were talking about passive voice. Yes, saying that we are going to be focusing all our attention, not in the subject, but in the one who is receiving that action, okay? And I'm going to be giving you some clues about this. Remember, active voice. My sister, I don't know, the dog eat his food or ate his food. No, I'm thinking about something in present or in past. Well, or I don't know, let's take this example. No, zombies chased my friend. That is active voice, the most common voice that we are going to be using. Passive voice. My friend was chased by zombies. First of all, the person or the people who is doing the action, your verb, and the one who is going to be receiving the action. That is in active voice. In passive voice, first of all, we are going to be having the subject that is receiving the action, then the action, and if you want to write, the one or the ones who were doing the actions. Ooh. And I'm going to be giving you some clues. I don't know why I cannot see this in a good way, but let me make it bigger. So, for example, in present, we are going to be having this. Zombies chase my friends in present. Well, in passive voice, we are going to be having this in present, obviously. If I say it in present, I'm going to have it in present. If I have it in past, my passive voice is going to be in past. But remember that my verb is going to be in participle. Well, my friend is chased by zombies. In past. Zombies chased my friend. My friend was chased by zombies. Future, zombies will chase my friends. Future, my friends will be chased by zombies. Present continues, zombies are chasing my friends. Passive voice in present continuous. My friend is being chased by zombies. Am I going to be using my past participle with passive voice? Yes, that is a clue that you are going to be making use of your past participle in order to be using your passive voice. That is the situation that we are going to be having. And also, yes, your verb to be or some conditionals, depending what you are saying. As we were mentioning during the past, the last class. Well, let me know if you have some questions with this topic, and I'm going to be helping you in order that we can clarify them. This just as a general review, okay? So if you have any question with passive voice, please, 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 please let me know, and I'm going to be answering to those questions. Well, remember about passive voice. My cousin painted this painting. Passive voice. This painting was painted by my cousin. If I want to use the complement, the person or the people who were doing the action, I can do it. I can write it, I can say it if I want. I'm going to be using the word by my cousin, by the father, by the mother, by the dog, by the penguins, and so on. The one who is doing or realizing or making the action, okay? That is how we are going to be making use of our passive voice. Oh, my cousin prepared the food. The food was prepared by my cousin. Okay, passive and active, active and passive. My verb in past participle with my passive voice. Please let me know if you have any question related to this topic. Well, remember, when I am going to be using passive voice? Well, we are going to be making use of our passive voice when we want to emphasize the action more than the subject that is performing it, because the action is more important. I don't care about the subject who is performing that action. I care about the action more than the subject, because this action is going to be more important. For example, more and more computers are sold every day. That is passive voice. Now, my question for this moment is, how can I change this sentence in passive voice into active voice? Good questions. What could it be? It could be, for example, I don't know, every day we sell more and more computers. More and more computers are sold every day by us, no? We are going to be using passive voice when we want to emphasize the action, not only the subject that is doing that action. Also, we are going to be making use of passive voice when the subject who is performing the action is obvious or unknown. For example, when we don't know who is the one that is performing the action, if he or she or they are pretty obvious. For example, the thief was arrested 2 hours ago. Ooh, we are emphasizing and we are talking about an obvious or unknown subject. Or we are going to be making use of passive voice when we want to avoid an active sentence whose subject is somebody or nobody or someone, etc. For example, the bank was robbed, by somebody. We don't want to say who was doing that situation, no? We want to avoid the subject that is going to be somebody or nobody. I mean nobody, no? Because we don't know the name. We don't know who he, who she is or who he is or who they are. That's why we are not going to be using active voice, but passive voice. When we want to say only, or when we want to mention only the action, we don't want to be mentioning the subject because it is not important, it is super obvious, or we want to avoid it. That is the passive voice. Ah, remember, we are going to be having the direct object and the passive voice. First of all, the papers were graded. And it's okay if you can have your first sentence without needing the subject, is because you are making use or you are using passive voice. The papers were graded and that's it. But I can compliment that adding the subject, not by the teachers. The papers had been graded by the teachers, different tenses. The papers will be graded by the teachers. The papers will have been graded by the teachers. The papers are being graded by the teachers. First of all, the direct object, okay? Or when you want to use, first of all, the object, that is going to be, we are going to be using active voice. The teachers graded the papers. The people or the person who is doing the action. Okay? The subject, the direct object or the direct object is going to be at the beginning and then the person or the people who were doing that, passive voice. I'm caring about the object that was involved into this, not about the people or the person who was doing or who were doing this situation, the action. Wow, easy or difficult? What do you think? Not so difficult, right? That's awesome. That was a general review for passive voice. Well, but remember, if you have some questions, let me know and I'm going to be helping you. Well, in order to finish with this, passive voice. We use passive voice when you are preparing a report or a subject. And when you are preparing a report and the subject is not known, like my pen was stolen yesterday. You are not mentioning the subject as I was telling you here, right? When we are going to be using, we don't want to mention the subject. Excellent, sorry. Or when you are writing a scientific paper, passive voice is going to be like more formal and you are going to be using passive voice in some specific cases. When you are preparing a report and the subject is not known, like my pen was stolen yesterday, it is not important to mention or to say or to talk about the subject, who was doing that action. Or when you are writing a scientific paper, or when the emphasis is on the action and the subject or subject is irrelevant. Who cares about subject? That's when you are going to be using passive voice. But also you are going to be avoiding to use passive voice when the subject is important to mention. When you don't really need to mention the subject, please avoid using passive voice, okay? Or when you need to write a clear message, please avoid using passive voice and use active voice. Or when you need to highlight the action of the verb, fix passive voice sentences and convert them into active voice. Those are going to be the three occasions when you are going to be avoiding using passive voice. When you don't want to mention the object, or when you want to emphasize the victim of the of that situation, when you want to be like more formal, when you want to write a scientific paper, when you are emphasizing, or you are the emphasis on is in the action and the subject is irrelevant, that's when you are going to be making use of passive voice. But you are going to be avoiding to use it when the subject is super important and you need to mention it, okay? When you need to write something that is going to be super duper clear, avoid passive voice and use your active voice, a normal voice. Or when you need to highlight the action of the verb, forget about passive voice and start with your active voice, okay? You can be changing them depending the needs that you have. One more time. Why should you avoid a passive voice, or why should you should avoid using passive voice? Well, if you want to write an article which is nice and easy to read, you should try to avoid passive voice. And also in sentences with passive voice, it remains unclear who or what is acting. That is the situation that you are going to be facing with passive voice. If you are going to be using passive voice, maybe your message is going to be a kind of hard or a kind of difficult to express or to understand, no? Talking about the readers. If you want to write something that is clear and nice and easy to understand or reading, you are going to be avoiding passive voice and you are going to be making use of your active voice. Okay. Or remember, if you want to mention the subject, or if you want that the subject or the one who is acting can be mentioned on that, you are going to be avoiding using passive voice and you are going to be writing with active voice. Okay, if it remains unclear who or what is acting yet. Remember that in the passive voice, it is not going to be super clear who is the person that is acting. And in active voice, it is going to be super clear because you are going to be emphasizing the subject, okay? Also, for instance, passive voice, this product can be bought in our webshop. This is going to be an advertisement. That is going that we are going to be using. Well, we are going to be practicing with this because after that, we are going to continue with our different verbs that I have. For that reason, what questions do you have? Remember, if you want to write a clear message, use active voice. If you want to write something like more polite, we are going to be making use of passive voice when we want to emphasize the subject. We are going to be making use of active. If we don't want to emphasize the subject because we don't know it, or it is not so relevant or important, and we want to emphasize the action, it is going to be passive voice, okay? So let's start practicing with this exercise that I have here for you. And you are going to be helping me because the practice is going to be super duper important. Well, let's start. You are going to be helping me with the answer, okay? Number one, Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire was written or wrote by G.K. Rowling. What do you think? was written by J.K. Rowling, remember, with passive voice. Your verb is going to be past participle, but not a lot. It is going to be needing a verb to be at least. Excellent. Next, J.K. Rowling, I don't know what. Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. Passive or active, what do you think? Good. I believe I'm not going to be helping you a lot. I'm going to be having some mistakes in order to have a general review with you. J.K. Rowling wrote Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. This is not passive voice. This is going to be active voice because I'm mentioning the subject for this sentence. The subject is going to be pretty important. Okay, the judge, I don't know what, Smith to 5 years in prison. The judge was sentenced or sentenced? Sentenced? Yes, the judge sentenced Smith to 5 years in prison. Active voice, the most important part is the subject and also the situation, not the victim. Smith, I don't know what. Now, this is going to be passive voice. How can I use the passive voice? Tell me. Smith was sentenced to 5 years in prison or Smith sentenced? Tell me. Was sentenced to 5 years in prison. Passive voice. Here the victim and the action is the most important for me. Next. Over $1 million in cash, I don't know, from a bank in Los Angeles has stolen or has been stolen. What do you think? Has been stolen. Passive voice. If I say this has stolen, who? This one has stolen? No. What happened to this? No, who is doing the action? What happened to that? Thieves, I don't know what, over $1 million in cash from a bank in Los Angeles. What do you think? Thieves have stolen. Yes. Am I going to be using my verb to be? No, as I told you, not all the time. Sometimes you are going to be making use of verb to be, have, modal verbs, depending your situation, but your verb is going to be always in past participle, and it is going to have company. It is not going to be alone. He's going to be with someone else, another verb. Excellent. I'll have to come by bus as my car, what? Remember your clue. If it is passive voice, you need to use your past participle. Oh, I will have to come by bus. Ooh, future with have to. Wow, impressive. I will have to come by bus as my car is being repaired. Wow, is repairing? Who is repairing? What is repairing? No. The goal, I don't know what, in a cave, near the top of the mountain. What could it be? What do you think? The goal, excellent. Who's discovered? Excellent. In a cave, passive voice, near the top of the mountain. Archaeologists, the gold in a cave near the top of the mountain. It is not passive voice, the emphasis is on the subject. Discover, excellent. Now the meeting, until the end of the month, the end of the month. What could it be? Has been postponed? Is being postponed? Has postponed? What do you think? What do you think? I has been postponed until the end of the month. Ha sido pospuesta until the end of the month. That's good. Next, we have the meeting until the end of the month. What do you think? What do you think? We have postponed the meeting until the end of the month. It is not passive voice, it is active voice. The emphasis is on the subject and on the situation. Next, VW cars, I don't know what, in Germany and the Czech Republic. Ooh, what did you think? Making, made, are made, made. What is it? What is it? Well, WW are made in Germany and in the Czech Republic. That is going to be the situation. Ooh, that's super cool. That's super cool. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Let's continue with the next one. Many shops, I don't know what, at around 9 in the morning. At around 9 in the morning. What do you think? Many shops are opened? No, told you. Many shops open around because it is not passive voice. It is going to be active voice. Well, be careful because we are going to be having some situation. Many shops are opened at around. Están abiertas alrededor de la 9 de la mañana. Puede ser, pero suena mejor. Muchas tiendas abren alrededor de las 9 de la mañana. Están abiertas alrededor de la mañana. That could be, depending what you want to be saying. Your letter yesterday morning. What do you think? What do you think? What do you think? What do you think? Your letter has arrived. Oh, sorry, no. Not everything is passive, boys. Was arrived? No. Your letter arrived. Don't worry about the score. We are checking. We are practicing. Your letter has arrived yesterday morning, depending the context, okay? Tu carta ha llegado ayer en la mañana. Well, that could it be possible. That's why it could be a kind of easy to get confused with this. But actually, it could be better if we focus our attention on the subject. Your letter arrived yesterday morning. My emphasis is on my subject, not on the verb, nor in the objective. Helmets must on the side. Helmets. What do you think? Helmets, los cascos, must wear on the side. Must are worn with a modal verb. Or be worn. Helmets must be worn on the side. Los cascos deben ser usados. We cannot say helmets must wear. Los cascos deben usar en el sitio. No. Vehicles park in front of these gates will what? Is passive voice. What could it be? This gate will remove? No. Removing? No. Will be removed? Yes, that's super cool because we are talking about passive voice. What do you think? The vehicles park in front of these gates will be removed. Los vehículos estacionados enfrente de estas puertas serán removidos. Vehicles. We will, I don't know, any vehicles parked in front of the gates. Vehicles. We will, I don't know what, any vehicles parked in front of these gates. We will removing. We will be removed. We will remove or we will have removed. We will remove. The emphasis is on the subject and the situation that we are going to be happening. Next. A number of people have arrested following a demonstration in central London. Have been arrested. A number of people have arrested. Como ellos han arrestado o han sido arrestados. They are the victims. Police, I don't know what, a number of people following a demonstration in the central London. Clue, the emphasis is here. Have arrested, police have arrested a number of people. These are the victims. This is the one who is making the actions. Police have been arrested. Los policías han sido arrestados. Un número de gente. No, never ever in your life, in my life, and in your life. It that the painting is a fake. It is now believed that the painting is a fake. It believed now. It is believing. Sure. It is now believed. Yes. Ahora es creído, es pensado que las pinturas son un fake. Expert now believe that the painting is a fake, or experts is now believed. Is with plural experts? No. Now believe because of the grammar and because of the emphasis. It, I don't know, if you could reply as soon as possible. It, passive voice. It would be appreciated. If you could reply, it would appreciate. It appreciate, eso aprecio si contestas tan pronto como sea posible. No. All bills must settle or be settled promptly. What do you think? Settle? No. All bills must be settled promptly. Passive voice. The emphasis. Next, two men, I don't know, following a robbery in the city center this afternoon. Two men are questioning or are being questioned. The context. Are questioning. Or are being questioned. Dos hombres están cuestionando seguidos de un robo en la ciudad o están siendo cuestionados. The two men are being questioned. And the last, police are being questioned because in the last, the emphasis is on the victims. Police, two men following a robbery in the city center this afternoon are questioning or are being questioning. Are questioning two men. Ellos son los que están cuestionando a estos dos hombres. That's good. How did you feel? Is it clear, passive voice, or what? What do you think? Esta kind of easy. Well, super duper cool. That was a passive voice. Let me know if you have some questions related to that, okay? Very good. Now that we were talking about a passive voice, and as you can see, or as you could see, we were having different verbs there in past participle. They are, some of them are going to be regulars and irregulars. For that situation, we are going to be talking about verbs. Yes, verbs are everywhere, and they are going to be super duper useful. For that reason, let's talk about regular verbs, but not only about regular verbs. We are going to be talking also about pronunciation. Pronunciation. Ooh, and let me tell you something. When we have regular verbs, the pronunciation of these verbs is going to be, well, it's going to be having only three ways. the sound D, the sound T, and the sound it. For example, played, walked, decided, decided. Not decided, no, decided. Walked with the T, played with D. Yes, Angie, but when I'm going to be using the sound D, the sound T, and the sound it or it? Well, that's what we are going to be learning today in this moment. For that reason, let me show you this. Ooh, phonetics, cool. How to pronounce the past tense of regular verbs? The ED, how can I pronounce that? I know it's a super question that most of us used to have or had in the past because it was like walked, excited. Nah, let me tell you that we are going to be having three pronunciations depending the verbs, okay? We are going to be saying wanted, no, wanted, kissed, loved, with D. Oh, yes, I already know that we are going to be having three kind of pronunciations for the end of the verbs, but how can I know how I'm going to be pronouncing them? Ah, well, here it is, your answer. Pronunciation of ED. As I told you, three forms, okay? But I'm going to be taking a little time in order to talk about this. Okay, so let's start with this. The letter, the sound T and the sound D. Ooh, let me tell you, as you have it here, the pronunciation of words ending in ED depends on the final consonant sound. Yes, the consonant sound is going to be the one in charge of the pronunciation of the words ending in ED. As I was telling you, there are three ways to pronounce it at the end of a word in English. It, to, or the. The pronunciation depends on the final consonant. Final consonant. No final sound or something like that. No, the final consonant. Oh, excellent. We are going to be having voiceless and voiced. Voiced, yes. What are the voiced sound? Well, it is going to be the voiced sound is going to be when you use the vocal cords and they produce a vibration or humming sound in the throat. Those are the voiced. Like, try to feel it on your throat. A vibration or a humming sound. Can you see the sounds? Vibration or humming on your throat. Cuando vibra o zumba, tus cuerdas vocales. Cuando tú, te, ¿cómo vas a saber cuáles son los sonidos que tienen, que son voiced, ¿no? Cuando en tu garganta las cuerdas vocales vibran o zumban con el la última consonante, sale, aparte del ED, o sea, la consonante que está antes del ED, ¿no? Por ejemplo, aquí la P, 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 esa es la última consonante. La L es la última consonante, no tomes en cuenta el ED. Offer, damage, love, use, amaze, rub, claim. Those are voiced, okay? Voiced, voiced with sound. Those consonants are going to be voiced, okay? Because they are vibrating, they are humming on your throat. And we are going to say cold, cleaned, offered, damaged, damaged, loved, used, amazed, roofed, claimed, with the D sound, with the D sound. Hace la D casi no suena. D, 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 D. Vamos a nivelar ahí la vibración con algo pausado. D, D, D. D. Cold, cleaned, offered, damaged, loved, used, amazed, roofed, claimed, with the letter D. Okay? D, 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 D. And also we are going to be having the voiceless. Voiceless, I mean without voice, without vibration, without humming. For example, the P, no vibration, no humming, the sound. Can you see? They are not humming. They are not vibrating on your throat. And for that reason, you are going to be ending your pronunciation with T. Helped, looked, sniffed, laughed, washed, watched, kissed, danced, fixed, the sound. Never forget the sound. Voiceless with T. Voiced with T. With T, sorry. T, because the pronunciation. Voiceless with T. Voiced with D. And the third pronunciation. When you have a T or a D, you are going to be pronouncing like it. When you are finishing your verb with T or D, with T or D, with the two sounds, you are going to be having this, it, it. For example, wanted. Need it. Okay. That is going to be the situation. Remember, voice it. You are going to be finishing with D. voiceless with D. And if your verb ends with T or D, it is going to be having the it. Okay. For example, here we have, hello teacher, hello beautiful teacher. We are going to be having these pronunciations. Cooked. Is it writing? No, cooks. Cooked, danced, typed, laughed, sketched, punished, snatched, walked, missed, hopped, stuffed, read, washed, watched, talked, practiced, helped, scuffed, teethed, flushed, switched, with T at the end, because these letters are not vibrating on my throat. But we are going to be having other letters that are going to be vibrating. And for that reason, they are going to be ending with D. Lived, harmed, phoned, called, preferred, changed, begged, bathed, advised, roved, climbed, banished, waved, confirmed, seen, healed, discovered, judged, pinched, clothed, realized, garaged, bombed, belonged, arrived, performed, cleaned, strolled, entered, encouraged, plugged, teethed, hypnotized, messaged, grabbed, stringed, with your d at the end, okay? And remember that if I have words that ends with T or D, we are going to be having it. For example, voted, minded, waited, sounded, wanted, demanded, voted, minded, waited, sounded, wanted, and demanded with it. Did you listen? Voted, minded, waited, sounded, wanted, demanded. Hey. T, D, and it. T, voice it. Voiceless, with what? With D. And with D, or T, with ET. One more time, remember, with the verb that doesn't have a vibration, the T. With the verbs that vibrates, D. And with the verbs that ends with T or D, ET. What do you think about this? Is it easy or difficult or more or less? Don't worry. We are going to be practicing about this in order that you can learn how to pronounce all these words. Don't worry. It is going to be easy. This is the presentation of the topic. We are going to be practicing and solving some doubts. Please let me know what questions do you have, and I'm going to be helping you to solve them. And also, let's practice with this. I'm going to give you some exercises in order that we can be practicing. And also, our next video is going to be about only these verbs, okay? Thank you very much for this opportunity of being with you. I hope to see you soon on Zoom, and I am going to see you soon in another video. Thank you very much, my sweet students. Wonderful, wonderful day, wonderful, wonderful night. See you in the next video. See you later.